Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. If you're someone who does keying in your post-production work, you should be familiar with an integrating technique known as light wrapping. This is the process of blending the edges of your key with a background. The purpose of this is to help give your composites a sense of realism. So the light and color of the background should wrap around your subjects, matching real-world physics, and the final result looks more aesthetically pleasing to the eye. Now there are many techniques, node trees, and shaders you could use to do a light wrap. However, it can be quite an involved process of creating edge mats, performing multiple blending, and finally recompositing everything back together again. With the Flame 2019.2 update, light wrapping has been introduced as part of the Action 3D Compositor. This means you can light wrap in the context of a live 3D scene. And the light wrapping is totally aware of all the other objects within the composite. This can help solve some really tricky blending issues when images overlap. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the description below. Alternatively, if you're watching the podcast, then please type the displayed link in your web browser. Import the footage into Flame and load the batch setup into the batch group. Now looking at the flow graph, I have already keyed out two talents using the modular keyer, and you can explore these keyers in your own time. The fill and the mats are fed into the action node, and this is composited over a sky background. If you go into action with the 2-up view using Alt 2, there are two image objects in the action schematic, which form the basis of the composite. Now none of these keys have any light wrap. If you select the man and hide him with H, we can focus on one key to start. Now zoom into the composite by about 300%. When you pan around the edges of the key, you can see it's a good key, but there is no visual connection between it and the background. This is when you'd use a light wrap. To add a light wrap to this key, you either select it in the composite or in the action schematic. And using the contextual menu, choose Add Light Wrap. A material node is added to the surface, and if you double-click on it, you will see a light wrap menu in the material controls. Now, image blending always happens at the surface level within the composite. This is the reason for having light wrapping within the material node. So the blend is aware of everything in the 3D composite, especially the background behind it. Knowing this fact will help automate the light wrap process. Click Active. With light wrap on, you should see a faint highlight on the edge of the key. The default settings are normally quite subdued, but we'll turn it up to make this really evident. Set the main amount to 50. That makes it more obvious. If you pan around the subject and toggle the light wrap, you'll see that it draws in the colors from the background and wraps it around the subject. This is not a singular color. It's pulling on the whites and the blues in the background to generate a natural light wrapping effect. Now frame the composite to the viewport, and let's look at some of the light wrapping controls. In the main control section, you can control the mix between the light wrap and the original image, as well as add noise into the light wrap if the blending gradient is too smooth. And in terms of what colors are used for the light wrap, you can soften the background input, as well as increase the saturation in order to amplify the colors. Leave it at 1.0 for now. Now the three layers are your options that generate the light wrap. They are all the same, but they default to different blending modes. Everything is editable, and by having multiple options, you can create compound effects within the light wrap. Now each layer has an effect, tolerance, and gain slider. The effect grows the edges of the light wrap mat, so the background starts covering more of the keyed image. Use this sparingly, so set the value to 1.5. Now gain boosts the color of the background within the light wrap. It's not designed to totally blur out your edges, so don't expect it to be brighter than white. Finally, the effect as well as the gain slider currently affect the edges uniformly. To break this up, you increase the tolerance slider, and this will remove parts of the light wrapping effect based on the luminance of the keyed subject. Set this to 50%. Toggling the light wrap on and off, you can see how the light wrap creates a natural spillage of light across the keyed talent. If you scrub the time bar, the light wrap will work across the entire composite, even if the background behind it is changing. Now let's add another layer to light wrap. Enable layer 2. The same options are applied over layer 1, but this time, layer 2 is screened over layer 1 as a different effect. Leave the effect slider as it is, but start pushing the gain to 1.3. Now push the tolerance towards 20%. So you can see how the light wrap layers are composited together when toggling the various ones on and off. Now you might think it's a tad too bright, so adjust the overall mix down to half. So there is the key with the light wrap, and there is the key without the light wrap. Like I said, it's a small difference, but it will definitely help with integrating your composites. Now let's take a look at what happens when other objects move behind a light wrap image in the 3D composite. Zoom into the arm of the female talent. Note the effects of the light wrap on her arm because of the background behind her. Select the man in the action schematic and unhide his surface with H. Taking a look at her arm, note that because he is obscuring the bright background, the light wrap no longer affects her arm. If you hide or even move his layer to reveal the background, the light wrap will use the brightness and colors in the background. Frame the composite to the viewport and toggle the light wrap on and off. You can see the rest of the female talent is still affected by the light wrap. So the action light wrap adapts to changes instantly. And if you've used older methods with flow graphs to achieve this, you'll know that it takes longer to adjust your light wraps when changes happen behind the keyed talent. Now, if you wanted to light wrap multiple keyed objects, you can do it all in one composite. For example, you could add another material node to the male talent and adjust his settings separately. But since this is action, and you can use nodes to drive relationships in the processing pipeline, you can connect the surface of the male talent to the same material node, and it will share the same light wrap as the other keyed talent. Adjusting these settings affects all the connected nodes. Toggle the result one more time to see the light wrap effect. As a final tip, if you need to blend the actual pixel edge of your key, which is considered separate from the light wrap, you could use the batch flow graph and a combination of nodes such as pixel spread and curves. But in keeping it all in action, I want to point out that each action surface has their own blending curves within the 3D scene. So you can adjust the luminance blend of your edges if they are too dark or too bright. So that's how to use light wrapping in action. But one final thought for you to ponder is that light wrapping is not just for flat image surfaces. You can also apply light wrapping to 3D geometry using the material node. Hopefully, this will help you with any future keying projects. And don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to the Flame 2019.2 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.